What makes a good faith community, a good Catholic parish?
It's not always perfect. We're not a perfect parish in any way, shape, or form, but we're a really good parish. When somebody has a need, we step up.
St. Gabriel Church outside Baltimore saw an immediate need and the opportunity to feed the hungry, those struggling with financial hardship during the pandemic. Parishioner Maureen Kelly told me why she's compelled to volunteer.
Yeah, spirituality is a huge part of this because I'm called by God to serve Him. So my service is this.
Monsignor Thomas Phillips says parishioners are taking the message they hear on Sundays to heart.
How we can put the gospel into practice here, really.
There's a connection between listening and the action that follows.
It's one thing to sit in church and listen to a homily, listen to scripture. There's another thing to take that out and put it in the field and make it work, and that's what's happening here.
In Arlington, Virginia, St. Charles Church is also actively living out its spiritual mandate.
We're all about the mission of bringing the good news of the gospel here to the heart of Arlington and doing it together, and we genuinely enjoy each other's company and love working together.
Father Don Planty is pastor here. Many of the people in the pews are young adults
who are really serious about their faith and really looking to not just go through the motions on Sunday.
But parishioners like Rohit Fonseca and Bulai Manana are involved in smaller communities within the greater parish, like prayer or social groups.
In my experience, it's most of the time it's friendship that brings people closer to God.
Forming relationships with one another, working to build up the life of the church.
The church is a family.
Simone Rizkala with Endow, a group helping to bring Catholic women together in parish communities, says a good church family, a parish, will first be rooted in the most important relationship, one with Jesus, and that starts with prayer.
We need to become what John Paul II said, schools of prayer, that parishes would become schools of prayer.
Everyone kept coming back to this central theme of prayer, including Father Thomas Ferguson at Good Shepherd Parish in Alexandria, Virginia.
I personally like to encourage people in preaching to really be attentive to their daily prayer and how God is calling us all to a deeper relationship through daily prayer.
The emphasis on prayer inspiring more action, people hearing and following God's call to give in different ways.
There's a strong emphasis on feeding the hungry at this parish. This pile of groceries isn't collected for an annual or monthly food drive. Parishioners are dropping off groceries here every Sunday before Mass.
And if you aren't sure how you're being called to serve, you might start with asking your priest how you can contribute.
That is music to a pastor's ears. I mean, there's always more stuff to be done.
The group Amazing Parish works to build up priests through coaching and support. The director, Kevin Cotter, says a good parish starts with good leadership, and a good leader needs the backing of his people.
Where a priest knows, these people aren't just here to tell me what to do. They're not just here to say, yeah, I'll pray for you, Father, but they're actually here for him as a person.
And Father Planty says his leadership starts with spending time in prayer with Jesus.
If I blow him off, I see the difference in my life. I can't live without that time I spend with him.
Maureen Kelly shared a similar thought.
You have to be able to listen. You have to listen to what God says. That means spending time in quiet.
And she says a spirit of gratitude will move you to love others.
That's our greatest gift, is to give back to God what He's given to us.
Mark Irons, EWTN News In Depth.